Good morning and welcome to the faith community of St. Maria Goretti and Our Lady of the Angels Parishes. Today, there is a second collection in support of four important outreaches of the Church: Catholic Relief Services, the Church in Latin America, the Church in Central and Eastern Europe, and the Church in Africa. All donations to this collection will benefit those suffering from disasters, as well as those countries. Today, we celebrate the seventh Sunday of Easter. Our presider is Brother Jonathan. Our gathering hymn is number 201, Immaculate Mary, number 201. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. So, good morning. First, the most important thing is that we have First Communion. Well, we just had a May crowning where we honor Mary now in the month of May. And the children, the young people that did the May crowning are receiving their first communion today. So Emma, Connor, and Francisco. So that's the most important thing. The second thing that's pretty important is, if you haven't heard, the CDC has removed the mask mandate if you have been vaccinated. So if you've been vaccinated and you feel comfortable not wearing a mask, you no longer have to wear a mask, even in here. If you haven't been vaccinated, please still wear a mask. We're still doing social distancing, but that is certainly good news. As we prepare to celebrate these most sacred mysteries, as Emma and Connor and Francisco prepare for their first communion, and we all prepare to receive Jesus' body and blood, let us ask God for his mercy and forgiveness. Put to death on the cross, you were raised to new life by the Father. Lord, have mercy. Your merciful love fills the whole world. Christ, have mercy. You are the good shepherd, leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Praise you, we bless you, adore you, we glorify you, give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, God Almighty Father. To God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Son of God, Son of the Father, you take away. To God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. The Father, glory, glory, glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Amen, amen, amen. Let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory may experience as he promised until the end of the world his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers. There was a group of about 120 persons in the one place. He said, "My brothers, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guide for those who arrested Jesus. He was numbered among us and was allotted a share in this ministry. For it is written in the book of Psalms, 'May another take his office.' Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time the Lord Jesus came and went with us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken up from us, become with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed two: Judas, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they gave lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
The Lord has
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, you mighty in strength, who do his bidding. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us of his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as a Savior to the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him, and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me. And I guarded them, and none of them was lost except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, I sent them into the world. And as I consecrate myself for them, so they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord. So right now we're kind of in an in-between time. In-between time in the church. We're still technically in Easter. Today is the seventh Sunday of Easter. But the resurrection appearances are done. There are no more, we won't hear any more resurrection appearances. Jesus has ascended into heaven. You know, we celebrate that on Ascension Thursday. And he's seated victoriously at the right hand of the Father. He has entrusted his disciples to carry on his mission. And he has promised them a helper, a comforter, his very spirit. You know, his spirit of courage, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. His spirit of counsel, piety, and awe. He has promised them the Holy Spirit. But the Spirit hasn't come yet. That'll be next Sunday, Pentecost Sunday. But in the meantime, or right now, it's an in-between time. The Holy Spirit hasn't come. And there's lots of uncertainty in the disciples and in the apostles. For 9 days between Ascension Thursday and Pentecost, you know, the apostles and the 120 disciples that we heard in the first reading, you know, they know things are going to be different, but they're not sure how they're going to be different. They're in the midst of transition, you know, going from a space of comfort, a space of familiarity, to another space, a space they know is going to be good, but they don't know exactly what it's going to look like. They're right on the cusp of it, and that can be an exciting but also an uncomfortable place. You know, we all know what it's like to go through transitions, to be, you know, stuck in an in-between time for a period. You know, transitions are happening to us all the time. The last 2 weeks, you know, I've been out of town. I was on vacation, and one of the people I visited on vacation was a whole bunch of family in Oklahoma, and I saw one of my cousin's children. And I think the last time I saw her, she was this adorable four-year-old. Next week, she's graduating from high school. So she's in transition. She's excited. She's excited to be getting out of high school, to end this chapter of her life. But she's also, you know, a little apprehensive about her next chapter in her life. You know, whether that's college or full-time employment, you know, there's going to be new faces, new places, new activities. And it's exciting, but it's also scary. And this is true for anyone, you know, anyone who's in the midst of changing jobs or positions or moving. I mean, in a sense, we're all in a transition right now as we transition from life of masks and COVID to a life of post-COVID and no masks. But we're not 100% sure what that's going to look like. Transitions can bring great joy, but also apprehension. You know, like earning a spot on the varsity squad or winning the lottery or expecting a certain bundle of joy to be added to your growing family. Some transitions we never want to go through, like the loss of a loved one, a loss of a spouse or parent or sibling or really close and intimate friend. These transitions can be especially difficult because, you know, everywhere we go and everyone we see, you know, can serve to remind us of the person we've lost. Some transitions aren't that dramatic. Asking to be taken a new responsibility at work, or move from one grade to the next, to join a ministry or get a new employee at your work. But every transition has an element of loss, but it also has an opportunity for growth, for greater self-knowledge. We all resist transitions, resist change to a certain extent, but we also know that it's inevitable. So regardless of what transition, what in-between time you're experiencing right now, whether it's a big or small transition, there are three things that we can learn from Scripture as the disciples, as apostles, go from their transition or are in their in-between time. The first lesson is to keep as much as possible to what you understand. Not everything changes. As Jesus ascended, the apostles did not know what was going to happen. They did not really know what to do. But they knew that they had been 12, and now they were only 11. 12 was a number that they were comfortable with. It was a number of significance for them. It was the number that Jesus picked. He had picked 12 apostles. It was the number of the sons of Jacob, the tribes of Israel. So Peter spoke up and insisted in that they're in their changing roles, that they needed to increase their number back to 12. But it couldn't be just anybody. It had to be someone that they were familiar with, someone that had been with the group the entire time, right from the beginning of Jesus' ministry. Someone who knew the dynamics and the development of their little group. Someone who had experienced and encountered Jesus as they had. And someone who was familiar in understanding in Jesus' way and mission. And even though they were in the midst of a transition, in the midst of an in-between time, they wanted to keep things as much as possible to what they understood. In our transitions, we need to do the same. We need to keep to what we understand as much as possible, especially to those things that have helped us through transitions in the past. Effective study or work habits, hobbies, good friends and family, but most of all, our faith. The second lesson we see in today in facing a daunting or challenging transition is to rely on prayer, to pray. And to ask for prayer. In choosing Judas's replacement, ultimately the disciples, put it in God's hands. Jesus prayed in the gospel today that his heavenly Father would keep his disciples as one, keep them united and faithful as they went through challenges, as they went through transition. Jesus promises his followers that if they ask for anything in his name, their prayers will be answered. That doesn't mean, all our prayers will be answered exactly as we desire them to. Tragedies will still occur. Disappointments will still happen. Loved ones will still be lost. But if we pray as Jesus taught us, that thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven, then we will grow in peace of mind. No matter what happens, our lives are in God's hands, and that we'll be given the grace and the strength to endure and even grow in any transition, no matter how difficult it might be. The final lesson that I can make out in these readings is to trust in the Holy Spirit. If we're willing to work with the Spirit in our life, we can trust that we've been already given every grace, every gift that we need to face any transition, any challenge or obstacle. Jesus did not expect his disciples to go from followers to leaders without, any help. And he gave them all the help they needed when he sent them the Holy Spirit. If you're going through or preparing for a transition, if you're in an in-between time and you don't feel prepared for it, you don't know what to do, make a novena to the Holy Spirit. You know, like the disciples crowded together who prayed for those 9 days between the ascension and Pentecost, they were given the power and the strength to do what they needed with the Holy Spirit. You know, trust your transition, trust your in-between time, trust your challenge to the Holy Spirit, and watch your fears and anxieties turn to confidence and know-how. The greatest transition any of us were ever going to make in this life is when we go from this life to the next. And Jesus assures us that you know, he's with us now and he will be with us then. Yet the in-between part, that transition, you know, that moving from this life to the next fills each of us with dread. But if we can trust Jesus in this life, if we can trust Jesus in the next life, we can also trust him in that in-between time. You know, Jesus, who lived for us, who died for us, who rose and ascended for us, will guide us now. He will guide us then, and he will guide us in any in-between time from now till then. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, and with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. So at this time, let us offer to God all our in-between times, our transitions, our challenges, our obstacles, our prayers, and our needs.
Our response will be, "Risen Lord, hear our prayer." For all the members of the church, that we may continue to follow the calling we have received as disciples to truly live as the body of Christ, giving glory to the Father, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the parishioners of our two parishes, that we may be guided by the Holy Spirit to grow in unity and may become the body of Christ for our neighborhoods, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those suffering from the coronavirus, whether physically, emotionally, or economically, that they may not lose hope and may find strength both in the Lord and in the care of those around them, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those members of our parishes receiving Jesus in the Eucharist for the first time this weekend, that they may remain in the presence of the Lord Jesus, whom they are receiving, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing for the sacrament of confirmation in our parishes, that they may be blessed with the promised gifts of the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick in body, mind, and spirit of our families, our parish families, and our world community, that they may experience the healing, peace, and strength they most need, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our deceased relatives and friends, we especially remember Mary O'Donnell and Angie Schleicher, who passed away this week, and for the deceased of the Jedlowick family, whose special intentions we remember at this liturgy, that they may experience the fullness of love and peace with our risen Lord, and for the blessings of peace and consolation upon all those grieving the loss of a loved one, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. And so on this month of May, we ask for the intercession of our Queen, the Queen of Heaven and of Earth, as we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen.
As the gifts are prepared, please join in singing number 432. Be not afraid, number 432.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Father in heaven. Amen. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and David our Bishop and all the clergy and the faithful. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. So now we'll have the first communicants to be the first to receive. The body of Christ. Good job. Good job. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Communion hymn is number 331, Taste and See, number 331.
So for those who are celebrating with us through the Facebook live stream, a prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries, there will be accomplished in the body of the whole church what has already come to pass in Christ, her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever. All right, please be seated. A moment for the announcements. Pentecost is next weekend, and we would like to have the praying of the intercessions in different languages at all masses that weekend, but we need your help. So far, we only have a couple folks signed up. If you know a language other than English and would be willing to pray one of the intercessions next weekend, please sign up in the back of the church. List your name, the language you know, and the mass time you prefer, and your email address. And we will send you the intercession that you would need to translate and pray on Saturday, May 22nd, or Sunday, May 23rd. Also for Pentecost, we are encouraging everyone to wear red if they can. This Wednesday at 6:30 in St. Joseph Church, there will be a planning meeting for our parish participating in Little Italy Days. Which is August 19th through the 22nd. We now have just 2 weeks to sell the remaining June lottery tickets. This fundraiser is for each of our parishes. The cost is $5, and each ticket gives you a chance to win $2,500 during the 30 days of June. Before yesterday's Mass, there were about 100 tickets left at Our Lady of the Angels. Don't know how many there are left now. And about 700 at St. Maria Goretti. The new COVID directives from the CDC and the diocese are that if you are vaccinated, you do not have to wear a mask in church. Those who are not vaccinated are still required to wear a mask. Social distance is still required until May 31st. But on May 31st, we are permitted to have 100% occupancy. We will have a section, though, in the church designated for social distancing for those who will feel more comfortable with that. Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries that are being celebrated this week that would like to be, I guess it's Bill's birthday? No? Okay, is it today or? Today, okay, well, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Any other birthdays or anniversaries? Well, so why don't we recognize our first communicants, Francisco, Emma, and Connor. Congratulations. All right, please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
As we are sent forth, please join in singing number 417, The Church's One Foundation, number 417.
How about you take that for me, and then I'll take the book. How'll that work? Good?